Scanning for audio.
Welcome to a Tin Dog podcast, one of perhaps three that might be coming out this week. Now at this point, you've probably already heard my review of The Impossible Astronaut, and if you haven't, it's on the feed somewhere. But this time, I just want to say a few words about Elisabeth Slayden. And before I play some of the audio files that I've got, consisting of the BBC News announcement that she died, the CBBC News Round, that's the kids' programme, the kids' news programme that comes out daily, talking about her, and Radio 4's tribute to Elisabeth Slayden. And then last, but by no means least, a recording made from the special BBC programme My Sarah Jane, which has interviews with Russell T Davies, Matt Smith, and David Tennant. I hope you enjoy all four of those files. But before I do all of that, and you get to hear those, I just want to share an email I received. Now this is from Colin, who you may also know as Abasok, from way back on Podshock. Hi Michael, I was updating my podcast when I saw yours appear on screen only for a fraction of a second, but long enough for the words, Elisabeth Slayden has died, to burn into my mind. I just sat there and thought, what? I half hoped it was a sick joke, and almost didn't want to check out the BBC website for confirmation. Like you said in your podcast, I'm absolutely stunned to hear of her death. She was a massive influence on my childhood, and the only woman I've ever had a crush on. Needless to say, this was way before genetics kicked in and it all went Pete Tong, I can honestly say she was my favourite Doctor Who character as a child, and that includes the Doctor. I was sad when she left the series and disappointed when her short-lived TV series didn't take off. When she appeared in School Reunion, I shed a tear at the end, thinking that was the last we'd see of her. I'm thinking I'm going to shed a lot more now. Like you, my first thought was to put on a DVD of Time Warrior in, but I decided against it. For the moment, I think I'll just spend the whole time blubbing. Sarah Jane summed up neatly in her final words to the 10th Doctor. No one's ever going to forget you. Anyway, just thought I'd share a few thoughts with a Doctor Who fan. All the best, Abasok. It was a great email. I received various others, but I just wanted to share that one. Enjoy the files. Wherever you are, Liz, we're with you.
The actress Elisabeth Slayden began her career at the Liverpool Playhouse, where she excelled as an assistant stage manager, so much so that she had to make deliberate mistakes in order to get her break on the stage. She later appeared on television in episodes of Coronation Street, Z Cars and Some Mothers Do Have 'Em, but she got her big break when TV producer Barry Letts discovered her and cast her as Sarah Jane Smith in Doctor Who, the role for which she will be best remembered, not least by historian and Doctor Who expert Dominic Sandbrook.
Elisabeth Slayden occupied a special place in the imaginations of millions of British children. As Sarah Jane Smith, the plucky investigative reporter with a nice line in feminist repartee, she played the best-loved human character ever invited on board the TARDIS. With her gigantic collars and fetching dungarees, she seemed the quintessential product of the 1970s, the age that fashion forgot. But unlike the Doctor's other companions, she kept coming back for more. Indeed, it was a tribute to Elisabeth Sladen's understated professionalism, as well as to the popularity of her best-known character, the producers kept asking her back. She returned to our screens no fewer than three times before, at last, the BBC yielded to reason and gave Sarah Jane her own series. But none of this could have been predicted in the summer of 1973, when the producers of Doctor Who asked a 25-year-old Shakespearean actress from Liverpool to play the Time Lord's new assistant. And yet, from the moment Sarah Jane first appeared, investigating mysterious disappearances from a top-secret research laboratory, it was obvious that here was something different. John Pertwee's Doctor might have seen off the Daleks, but how would he cope with the challenge of feminism?
We need somebody around here to make the coffee.
If you think I'm going to spend my time making cups of coffee for you, what are you going to do in there?
Make myself a cup of coffee.
Of course, Sarah Jane mellowed eventually. After all, it's hard to focus on the struggle for women's liberation when you've been taken prisoner in the Middle Ages by an alien commander from the 5th Sontaran battle group. But she never quite lost her feminist edge. After all, Sladen herself was part of a generation of working women with broader horizons than ever before. This was the age of women's lib, bra burning, and the female eunuch. And while Sarah Jane was fighting off an infestation of giant insects on a space station in the far future, another formidable independent woman, Margaret Thatcher, was becoming leader of the Conservative Party. But although Sarah Jane survived the regime change from John Pertwee to Tom Baker, with whom she travelled for another three series, time caught up with her eventually. In 1976, the Doctor was summoned back to his home planet. After all they'd been through together, he kindly offered to drop her off in South Croydon. True to form, though, trouble with the TARDIS sat-nav meant that she ended up on the other side of London. But although Sladen moved back to Liverpool and concentrated on stage work, this was far from the end for Sarah Jane. Her lively, pugnacious personality, happily allied to girl-next-door good looks, meant that she had become a national favourite. And when Doctor Who returned in the 21st century, so eventually did Sarah Jane, hooking up again with her old flame, now in the form of David Tennant. But goodbyes in Doctor Who rarely last for long. Sarah Jane's return made such an impression that Elisabeth Sladen was summoned back yet again for a spin-off series, The Sarah Jane Adventures, which ran for 4 years on CBBC. By then, the feisty feminist had grown up. The dungarees had long since disappeared, replaced with a smart leather jacket. But deep down, she was the same old Sarah Jane, inquisitive and fearless to the last. Sadly, she never did find someone to replace the Time Lord in her life, for when she did make it to the altar with a promising chap, the Doctor burst in at the vital moment to reveal it was all a diabolical plot by a time-travelling trickster. But now the TARDIS has carried Sarah Jane away for good, and children from 5 to 50 must learn to live without her. And as the Doctor himself memorably put it,
I had to face my fear.
Please, don't die.
A tear? Sarah Jane? No, don't cry.
Dominic Sandbrook on Elisabeth Sladen, who's died aged 65.
I learned a long time ago that if you're missing somebody, just look up at the night sky. Whoever it is, wherever they are, chances are they're looking at the stars just like you. Sometimes for all its size, the universe isn't such a big place after all.
When you've watched a lot of Doctor Who, you're sort of a bit starstruck. Even when you're playing the Doctor, if you meet a sort of former companion or anyone that's been in it to any degree. I was a bit like, whoa, I'm working with Sarah Jane.
It's you, isn't it? Oh, you've done it again.
Hello, Sarah Jane.
Doctor?
I knew she was one of the most popular companions that there's been. And I just think it's wonderful that she had that wonderful resurgence in the world of Doctor Who, but also reconnected with an audience of children. I'm sure there are so many children, you know, out there in the world now who are completely devastated, like us all, because it was kind of like a fairy tale comeback for a Doctor Who character.
Hiya.
And then she, you know, not only did she just come back, she went off and had her own show. Not only was it her own show, it was a complete smash hit. And I think so much of that is down to her and her spirit, and she was cool, man.
When I was a kid, it was the Doctor and Sarah. That's what I knew. I suppose I started watching Doctor Who in the early 70s, which is when Liz was first on the show. And she was the ultimate Doctor Who girl. It was the Doctor and Sarah. That was the team.
So, providing we don't burn up on re-entry and aren't suffocated on the way down, we'll probably be smashed to a pulp when we land.
Exactly. Sarah? You've put your finger on the one tiny flaw in our plan.
Our plan? It's your plan.
Well, I'm open to suggestions if you've got a better idea.
In terms of Sarah Jane, I was that viewer. I was
how old, 10 or 11 or something, when she came on screen, perfect age to be a Doctor Who fan. And so I remember everything. I remember every single episode she ever did. I have seen them all. I saw them all on transmission, and I've seen them all since on DVD. So it's so hard now to think of stuff that sums her up. I always love, there's a great, great moment in the Ark in Space where she gets stuck in a ventilator shaft. Sarah Jane gets stuck, and the Doctor is rude to her. He pretends she's let him down in order to get her cross, in order to make her get through the ventilation shaft. That's a lovely bit of acting off Lis Slayden and Tom Baker. There's a million memories like that.
Hundreds of lives at stake, and you lie there blubbing.
You wait till I get out. I can manage. I don't need your help, thank you.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
I remember her in the Andy Pandy outfit with the Hand of Fear and a Tupperware box. And indeed, that final scene where she thought she was leaving the Doctor forever. That brilliant scene between Liz and Tom Baker, where they part company.
Don't forget me,
Sarah. Don't you forget me?
Bye, Doctor.
Bye.
You know, travel does broaden the mind.
Yes. Till we meet again, Sarah.
Sarah Jane Smith was for me the kind of the acme of companions that all the others had to follow, really. I think that was more than just a chance of time. I think Liz did make such an impact with that character. Which is why I guess she was the obvious choice to revisit the show when I took over.
Hello, Sarah Jane.
It's you. Oh, Doctor. Oh, my God, it's you, isn't it? You've regenerated.
Yeah, half a dozen times since we last met.
You look incredible.
So do you.
The school reunion episode was only ever imagined as a one-off, a kind of nod to the past. But because Liz was so great and so effervescent and so magical, actually, it was inevitable that Sarah Jane was going to come back and back into Doctor Who again, and then, of course, into her own wonderful series.
Ready? Always.
As soon as I heard the Sarah Jane Adventures was happening, I was always really keen that the Doctor should make an appearance.
What are you taking me for, Sarah? I just thought I'd go the quick way.
Oh, I like it in here.
Can we have a look?
What, in the TARDIS?
My TARDIS?
Of course you can, yeah.
I'm just so proud I got to work beside her because she was such a huge part of my childhood, and now she got to be a huge part of my adulthood as well, and it's a real privilege.
Oh, what does this do?
Hey. Touch.
Of seeing her with the other guys in the show who play the kids, she really did have this quality of youth, and they love her, you know, and they loved her.
She really just kind of like took us under her wing, and it was like, you know, it's on set and like day in, day out, she'd just be checking, oh, like, you all right, how are you doing so far, like, you enjoying it, like, what are you finding hard, anything that I can help you with. She was, yeah, really just helpful all the time. When I first started, it was like a straight away, it was just like a nice little family bond.
And then, yeah, I came on for the, obviously, when the series started, and it's definitely a family atmosphere. It always was. And Liz definitely, you know, she always took anyone new coming in under her wing and guided them through and made it so easy and comfortable. And yeah, it was incredible. She's a wicked person.
Thank you, Rani. Hello, Luke. Welcome home.
She puts so much into her character, so much integrity and passion, and she just loved the show so much, but also her character. She really fleshed her character out with so many elements of herself. She gave so much of herself into Sarah Jane, and that's why she was so loved. That's why she was so amazing.
Oh, you're going to make a lovely bridesmaid.
You're on. And there's that wedding fair.
I know. And your mum can do the flowers before she asks. Oh. Right, come on. Everybody out. Things to do.
I think she's such a key player in the whole Doctor Who family. Definitely. I think elements of her have rubbed off on the companions we have now.
she's what we looked at. I mean, she's what I looked at is to get some of the energy behind Captain Jack. She's what all the assistants, all of the best friends of the doctors will look at to see how it is done. You know, not only that, but she with Sarah Jane and having the Sarah Jane adventures and everything. It's just, it's a huge loss to our Doctor Who family and our Doctor Who world.
She's very much part of the CBBC family, as well as the Doctor Who family. I mean, you know, the responses that we've been getting on Newsround's website, you know, is a testament to that. Some 3,000 hits, you know, from people who just want to say how much they're going to miss her and how much they loved her.
I was really upset about this devastating news. She will be sadly missed by everyone, young and old. And that's from Grace Emily, 11. Elisabeth was a legend. No one will ever be as good as her. She will sadly be missed by everyone. Rest in peace, Elisabeth Slayden. It's from Olivia.
I think it's very important to remember what someone did rather than what someone is not going to do anymore. You know, I found that personally. I lost my granddad, and you find it hard to come to terms with the fact that you're not going to see that person again. But on the flip side of that, when you just talk about them and remember the kind of people that they were and what they were capable of doing, it's a very good thing to be able to do, you know. And of course, the Sarah Jane Adventures, there's so many things to talk about, isn't there? So many cool things that she did. And so I would just say that I hope people are going to do that. You know, I hope they're going to think about what they loved about her and what she did, and celebrate the fact that she was here and not that she's gone.
I tell you what, a lot of response that you hear from a lot of us that knew her now was, I wish she'd known how good she was, and I wish we'd known how loved, that she could have known how loved she was.
Sorry, do I know you?
We've never actually met, but it's Jo Grant, isn't it?
Wow, it's a long time since I've been called that. Liz was absolutely lovely because, A, we shared in common the fact that we both worked with the wonderful John Pertwee. And so we were able to laugh and talk quietly about the times of working with John and the trials and occasional tribulations of working with that remarkable man.
I told you I'd get you home safely, didn't I?
Oh, all the cheek.
Well, it's not my fault if people get up to no good while we were away.
Alien monsters, robber barons, then dinosaurs. It'll be a long time before I get in that TARDIS again.
What a legacy, that wonderful woman. The quintessential Doctor Who girl. I give her that title with absolutely no qualms at all.
What they told me about you. You must be Sarah Jane Smith. Oh, darling.
After all this time.
Lis Slayden has left us and we'll all remember her. And I would like to think that Sarah Jane, in our hearts, will just carry on forever.
The very fact that this same character could traverse all these decades and be as important to children now as she was to me when I was a kid, I think speaks volumes about how extraordinary she was. She will be remembered forever by my generation, by the current generation, and I'm sure by generations to come.
She may be the face I can't forget, a trace of pleasure or regret, maybe my treasure or the price I have to pay. She may be the song the summer sings, maybe the chill the autumn brings, maybe 100 different things within the measure of a day.
Miss Smith.
Yes, Professor?
Come and meet your namesake. Miss Lavinia Smith,
Dr. John Smith. How do you do, Miss Smith?
Sarah Jane Smith, journalist.
You're a good girl, Sarah.
You're going to do exactly as I say, or I'll blast you to oblivion. Hello?
Oh, I should think so.
Does he still stroke bits of the TARDIS?
Yeah,
he does. I'm like, do you two want to be alone?
She may be the reason I survive, the why and wherefore I'm alive, the what I'll care for through the rough in ready years. Me, I'll take her laughter and her tears, and make them all my souvenirs. For where she goes, I've got to be. The meaning
oh, I love
of
you.
My life is
Bummer.
She. She.
Goodbye. She. My Sarah Jane.
The actress Elisabeth Slayden, who starred in Doctor Who and the spin-off series The Sarah Jane Adventures, has died. She was 63 and had cancer. Many tributes have been paid to the Liverpool-born actress. Jane Frances Kelly looks back at her life.
We're talking about the Daleks, the most evil creatures ever invented. You
cast as the sidekick, Elisabeth Sladen's on-screen energy, warmth and humour turned her character Sarah Jane Smith into a star. She first appeared as Doctor Who's assistant in 1973, alongside John Pertwee and then opposite Tom Baker.
Is this the last time I'm ever going to see you?
She returned to the role on numerous occasions, notably with David Tennant.
Don't forget me, Sarah Jane.
Soon after, she was given her own spin-off series, The Sarah Jane Adventures. Its creator, Russell T. Davis, described her as funny, cheeky and clever.
We had a glorious time. I mean, if I'm glad about anything in my career, I'm so glad we did that, just so the whole new generation of children could fall in love with Sarah Jane Smith and with Elizabeth Slayton. I'm so happy that happened.
The current Doctor Who, Matt Smith, has also paid tribute, saying what struck me about Liz was her grace. She welcomed me, educated me, and delighted me with her tales and adventures on Doctor Who. Elizabeth Sladen's appeal stretched across the generations, and she will be missed by fans both young and old.
The actress Elisabeth Sladen, who died yesterday.
Hello there, you're with NewsRound. Ore and Sonali, your hosts this evening.
All day today we've been reporting the news that Elisabeth Sladen, star of Doctor Who and the Sarah Jane Adventures, has died.
Liz passed away yesterday after being ill with cancer, and you've been sending in hundreds of tributes to our website. Tonight we'll be looking at your favourite memories from her shows.
And hearing from some of her co-stars.
There's definitely an empty attic in Ealing now. The TARDIS has got a little bit smaller.
Elisabeth Sladen, of course, played one of the most popular characters on CBBC and in Doctor Who's long telly history, Sarah Jane Smith.
All day, hundreds of you have been showing just how popular. We've had more than 2,000 messages saying how much you loved her, her character and her TV adventures.
Before we hear some of your thoughts on the news, here's Ricky with a look back at how Elisabeth became one of CBBC's best loved stars.
Elisabeth Sladen, you know her best from the Sarah Jane Adventures.
I have been monitoring the news.
But for nearly 40 years, she's been entertaining not just you guys, but your mum, your dad, and probably your grandparents as well.
Have I that right?
To destroy the Daleks, you can't doubt it.
But I do.
It's nearly 40 years since she first appeared on Doctor Who. She starred as the Doctor's assistant for 3 series, but she was so popular, they kept inviting her back.
Please, Colin, not yet! The Doctor's still inside!
A few minutes, please.
In total, she acted alongside 6 Doctors, and then in 2007, she got her own show right here on CBBC.
What?
No one was surprised that the Sarah Jane Adventures became a massive hit. Her warmth and her humour made Elisabeth hugely popular with fans and everyone who worked with her. The creator of Doctor Who, Russell T. Davis, said Elisabeth was cheeky, funny and clever. He also said that a lot of children would have needed a hug this morning after waking up to the news.
Bye, Doctor. Until the next time.
Don't forget me, Sarah Jane.
No one's ever going to forget you.
And here in the CBBC office, presenters have been remembering what it was like to work with her.
She was just so cool, wasn't she? You know, I think you'd want to fight aliens with her. I would quite happily follow her on any adventure she ever took.
There's definitely an empty attic in Ealing now. The TARDIS has got a little bit smaller, which is a bit upsetting.
Elisabeth died after being ill with cancer. Over the past few months, she'd begun filming the 5th series of the Sarah Jane Adventures, but we don't know yet whether the episodes will be shown.
Well, as we said earlier, hundreds of you took time to message us today with your best memories of Liz.
Here are just a few of the ones we've been putting up on the Newsround website. It's one of the biggest responses we've ever had.
It really is, yeah. 10-year-old Lindsay from Pathhead says, "It's very sad about Elizabeth. My dad is also upset because he remembers when she was on Doctor Who."
Harry from Devon told us he wants to be an actor because of her character, Sarah Jane. And Caitlin from Swindon says, "I miss you. You were great at acting. Your show was my favourite. Goodbye."
12-year-old Narusi from London agrees. "She was a really good actor in Me and My Brother. Minesh will really miss her."
8-year-old Lucy's favourite scene was the first time that she was on the Sarah Jane Adventures in the Bubble Shock Factory. Now, some of you might remember that one.
CBBC's Chris Johnson definitely does, I'm sure. Last word goes to 11-year-old Kyle from Swansea, who says, "No one can or will replace her."
Well, we'll do our very best to put as many of your memories up on our website as we can. Thank you very much for getting in touch to tell us what you're going to miss.
I hope they were okay. Be seeing you.
You have been listening to the Tin Dog Podcast. Doctor Who and its associated shows are all trademark of the BBC. No infringement is intended. Contact us at tin-dog@hotmail.co.uk.